this is American Heretic. I was very, very, very lucky, having been very, very unlucky my whole childhood, to meet a teacher when I was about 21, who was a macrobiotic teacher, who was an American. He ran a group for people. He ran the HIV and cancer group in Philadelphia, a town I hate. But if I hadn't been there, I wouldn't have met him. And that's the way life is. I would go over in the morning and cook with him, and or he would be delivering his meals, and then he would pick me up, and we would go prep the next day's food. And we talked about yin and yang, and we talked about history, and we talked about five element theory. During that period of life, I must have read 20 significantly large books in, you know, 6-8 months, written by people over generations about food and energy. Now, I'm not a joiner of cults, and you know, the macrobiotic diet at that point in the very early 90s was still pretty brown ricey. And, you know, I tried that a couple of times. If that's too much rice for me, I'm not doing it. Which was fine, because the principle that appealed to me most in macrobiotics, besides yin and yang and basic elements of Taoism, was this one, called non-credo, credo. Credere is Latin Italian for to believe, and non-credo means I do not believe. In other words, the principle of this diet wasn't a diet, it was a philosophy that engaged you to become a scientist, to use that word correctly, a researcher in your own life, an experimenter in your own life, to look at what life was doing in and around you, what food did to you, what eating at certain times of day or not eating at certain times of a day did to you. There were guidelines, there were some principles. The principles were philosophically open-ended and very interesting. Everything is a differentiation of one infinite unrecognized thing. We can't recognize infinity, but we manifest as paired opposites, in almost an infinite number of paired opposites, encountering, well, we're really the infinite thing encountering itself in this manifestation. The energies of the universe seem to manifest in a sequence of energy that can be called five element theory or five energy theory. You can take it or leave it, but it's interesting. And those energies or elements have a great application in dividing food into various camps, into which they food types, pungent, sour, sweet, salty, and bitter fit very, very well. The five tastes fit into the five elements. So this was a very useful system on a very practical level to make sure you were getting enough and some of everything. The philosophy was, now you're going to experiment. You're going to eat locally grown foods. Well, good luck in America, but you're going to try to eat seasonally appropriate, climactically appropriate foods. Of course, I broke the rules all the time. I was allowed to. It was non-credo. I was allowed to do experiments. I did experiments. I ate a lot of bananas. I got allergies. If I stopped eating bananas, the allergies went away. I don't eat bananas anymore because I'm tired of having allergies. It's just that simple in my body. I don't eat high-growing, very yin tree fruit, and I don't, whatever, expectorate out of my eyes and nose and attract the pollen in the air. I guess I could write a whole book called The Banana Cure. Stop eating bananas and get rid of your allergies, but I'm just not that kind of guy. I have that experience. I did many experiments with food. I ate nothing but rice for 2 days, went crazy, said, I know what it feels like to be a grain of brown rice, and thank you very much, I'm out. I found that the foods that I liked, I'm more of a pasta person, whole grains, a lot of vegetables. They said, don't eat nightshades. I said, I'm eating nightshades. I've had too many animal foods. I need to dislodge some of this stuff from my body. This is the oxalates will be bad for you. I said, I'll be fine. I'm more or less fine. You know, I adjusted my diet season to season. They didn't say be a vegan. There was no word in macrobiotics for vegan. There was no word for paleo. You were supposed to eat what we, the human species, developed as food during this long cycle of civilization. You can eat some ancient foods. You can eat some wild crafted foods. You're not supposed to eat the filthy inner organs of animals 24 hours a day or for every meal. This is emergency food. These are vitamins. If you're going to eat the liver of an animal, as per the Sally Fallon instruction, you really should choose a small animal that hasn't accumulated a ton of toxic shit in itself. You don't want to be eating poison in the large organs of large animals. But that's what the Sally Fallon, and I'm not going to associate her with Weston Price, she's her own thing. But the Sally Fallon organization just wants you to not pay attention to the energetics of food. There's no concept in the paleo diet of the energetics of food. There's no concept in any of the new diets that are popular, or even the Dean Ornish diet, or the, who's the other skinny vegan, I can't remember, the guy running around saying low-fat, 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 low-fat. There's no concept of the energetics of food in any of these polar extremes. But food is energy. We relate in our bodies the energy of the food that we've been eating. It forms the way that we interact. If you eat big animals all the time, you're full of big animal hormones all the time, and I guarantee you're gonna feel it. I did an experiment recently having some beef broth. I have not felt that aggressive for years. I just drank some beef broth. I just, you know, cuz, non credo, I want to do the experiment. I hadn't eaten beef forever. I'm sure I'd have some pork because I eat at Chipotle and they used to put pork in their beans. I didn't even realize it. That I was eating a little bit of pork fat, but I very consciously went out, had some big, big, big animal hormones, and I very much felt it. I felt very strong and driven in a way, but I also felt, frankly, just a little more one-sided. And I felt myself, my face kind of got more expanded, and I feel like, well, if I went down that path, I imagine I would accrue some, you know, size. You see people, pictures of people when they're young and they're and healthy and they're quite thin, and in America when people get large their ankles are the size of their heads. What the fuck happened? Well, it's called large animal hormones, and people are just imbibed, they're drinking this stuff down all the time. I don't mean once in a while on Minerva's feast day or anything like that. I mean every day people think they need as much large animal hormones as they can get. But food is energy. The raw food vegans are fucking crazy. Raw food veganism is insane. Unless you're on some kind of cancer healing diet and you're going very, you know, very green and the Gerson kind of therapy, eating all that fruit sugar is just going to blow your head up through the roof. You're going to be like, wow, man, well, dude, yo, dude, everything. You're not going to be able to ground yourself. Food is supposed to be grounding. You're supposed to eat root vegetables because they ground you. And if that doesn't sound scientific enough, that's fine. You can go find the molecular analogs in root vegetables and ground vegetables that say, well, actually, we find this does create a feeling of satiety and restfulness in the brain. More funding is needed to formalize this study. Fuck off. If you eat grounding vegetables, you will feel grounded. I have 20-something years of experience figuring out how to make my body essentially feel any way I want to. I can be as calm as I want to. I can eat root vegetables and ground vegetables. I can be as spastic as I want to. I eat high tree fruit and caffeine. I can feel aggressive by eating some animal foods or deep fried foods. Or I can just be kind of calm. I can eat a nice plate of whole grain pasta with some olive oil, which the, is it Caldwell? I don't know. There's a guy who says you're not supposed to eat olive oil. Oh, fuck off. Fuck off. This is the ancient food of the birthplace of civilization. This is the Mediterranean staple food. In case of emergency, we grow olive trees. Fuck off, people who don't want me to eat olive oil. And fuck off, people who want me to eat nothing but calf brains and giant animal livers. Don't you know the meaning of a food chain? Can't you find your way to the middle of that energetic cycle instead of extremes? Always on the extremes. Americans are always on the extremes. Why don't we see food as energy? Why don't we decide that food is actually an energetic process outside of our bodies that we're internalizing? And that we internalize the feeling of it. There's a good reason not to spray things with poison. Biochemically, we don't want to absorb the poison, but we also don't want to absorb a plant that's been struggling against growing up inside of a poison. We're not getting a very healthy plant. The soil is not healthy, not just in a reductionist sense. Yes, that too, but we are going to absorb the health of the life of the thing that we're taking in. And now people say, I'm eating pasture-raised. You're eating pasture-raised dinosaurs. You're eating pasture-raised giants. You're still eating giant animal hormones. And for those of you who buy into the Sally Fallon crazy argument that, you know, soy is the danger food because it blocks mammalian estrogens, just say that to yourself three times. Soy blocks the uptake of mammalian estrogens. Don't eat GMO anything, but leave the beans alone. Really, Sally, leave the beans alone. You're crazy. And I don't think that anything she says could stand any kind of nutritional review. But people buy into the Weston A. Price Foundation, not because he was wrong about everything, but because they know that the American food system is crazy. But then they get knocked back to what they think their grandparents grew up with, which might not have been that healthy, because Americans have never understood food, ever. Food is energy. Food is not just reductionist parts, or you need more protein because. Food is not the paleo argument that more protein is better because you can trick your body into losing weight by starving itself and pouring acid into your blood. That's not a healthy diet. Think about food as energy. Think about the energy as having to be treated well when it was around. And I don't just mean animals, I mean plants too. I don't mean you have to talk to them and sing them songs. I mean put them in a nice field with some good, you know, horse shit in it, or, you know, some good, horse shit, or some good compost. Let's think about growing food where we live so that we have enough to eat, not so that we all can all be paleo and eat bacon chocolate, which isn't food, it's a stunt. That's nothing. I mean, there's no good energy in that. That's just crazy. It's a million kinds of stimulants, a million kinds of toxins, and you're not getting the benefit of any of the kinds of foods because you're overwhelming your body with poison. If you're going to eat a little poison, eat a little poison. One of the lessons that I did take from macrobiotics is if you're going to do something bad, don't do it three times. If you're going to eat a shitty food, don't do it twice in a row. Have your shitty food and go back to a normal healthy diet. And we all know that a normal healthy diet is grains, beans, vegetables, lots of vegetables. We all know that. We all know that soups and stews and stir fries are good for you. We all know that soups and stirs and stir fries go with a little bit of corn or a little bit of rice or a little bit of quinoa or a little bit of pasta. We all know this. We know it instinctively, and people kill themselves not to eat pasta anymore. Why don't you just support the organic pasta makers and not worry about a few carbohydrates? The only reason they're going to make you fat is because your body's in ketosis, and finally it's grabbing on to something that it can actually use for energy. You're going to have to wean yourself off of the starvation bandwagon and think about food as energy. Treat your body as though you're not trying to trick your liver into starving itself. Treat your body as though it were kind of something that you cared about. It was your friend. Treat diet as something that you experimented gently with. Eat in the middle. Find that middle ground. The middle ground is definitely not excluding some beans and some grains or pulses or near grains like buckwheat or quinoa, things that are full of carbohydrates, which is what your body uses for energy. There's nothing that your body uses for energy but carbohydrates. There's nothing. It has to convert fat and protein into carbohydrates, thus spilling acid into your blood during the process to get it to become something it can use for energy. Why do that? Why not just enjoy some olive oil, some sesame oil, some hemp seed oil, some flaxseed oil, some good oil with your food, instead of having to eat a giant cut of steak or pork with the lard in it because you read somewhere that lard is the new health food? Go read about go read about cholesterol. Just take a day and go read about cholesterol. Go ahead. Be a reductionist for a day. Find the pro and con arguments. And when you're done, you'll just want a very little. I didn't say you had to be a vegan, but you'll just want a very little, because you'll realize that the body is resilient, but you don't want to beat the shit out of it. We don't know what food is in America. Nobody does. Everybody's looking for the new perfect food. Everybody's running from diet to diet to diet to diet to diet. I have my new guru. This guy talks to angels. This guy talks to so-and-so. This guy talks to his feet. He tells me what to eat. Stop it. Start trusting yourself to experiment with food. Eat organic, eat lower on the food chain. You do not have to be a vegan. You don't have to get into fights with vegans. You don't have to eat horse. You don't have to be Andrew Zimmern and eat horse test. You don't have to eat things that are nightmarish to be healthy. You can heal your body and be relatively healthy and live a decent life, as people have done for thousands and thousands of years, without being absolutely insane on, thrown to one extreme or the other. Now, which book should I read, Liam? People always ask. Well, I like the book called Healing with Whole Foods, because it will not prescribe a particular diet. It just tells you what food is. It's by Paul Pitchford. I don't get any kickbacks for it. If I did, I would have a lot of money, because I constantly sell that book. I'd read Healing with Whole Foods. I'd look at Steve Gagné's work, Energetics of Food or Food Energetics, to think about what food is energetically rather than just as a reductionist where you just think that more protein is better or less protein is better or phytates are terrible because they da-da-da-da-da-da-da. It's not worth it. Try to think five ways about food.